for your service. When Congress created the Federal Reserve, they created arguably the most powerful institution in the whole world. Our whole economy, all our prosperity, wealth, rests on the soundness of the dollar, as does much of the economic systems all around the world. So as we consider your renomination, it's important that we ask some difficult questions, not just of you, but to ourselves, because no one can say that there haven't been major failures. And I think a lot of us have to admit that the federal government, the Federal Reserve, let down the American people, and a lot of people have been hurt. I will take exception to one of the arguments that I've heard today, and I've heard often, about what we heard last October and what actually happened. That we were told if we did not appropriate nearly $1 trillion to buy toxic assets, that the whole worldwide economy or economic system was likely to collapse. We appropriated nearly $1 trillion and we never bought one toxic asset, and the world economic system did not collapse. Now, we can make a case and debate all we want about whether or not twisting banks' arms and forcing more money into the banking system actually helped us. We could talk about that all day. But the premise that we used to create this TARP program was never followed through on. It's difficult for me to find credibility in the arguments that we saved our economy. But I'd like to ask a few questions, Mr. Chairman, and I appreciate short answers. I want to cover some territory today, but we don't know a lot about the operation of the Federal Reserve, and for that reason, I think the way to judge performance is to look at outcomes, particularly outcomes based on the goals that you've set for yourself. And in your confirmation hearing in 2005, you specifically listed four duties of the Federal Reserve, and I'd just like to mention those and just ask you how you think we've done. One of them was fostering the stability of the financial system and containing systemic risks that may arise in the financial markets. Has the Federal Reserve, under your leadership, accomplished that goal?
No, but we also have lots of other co-conspirators in that problem.
Another duty you listed, supervising and regulating the banking system to promote the safety and soundness of the nation's banking system and financial system. Has the Federal Reserve, under your leadership, accomplished that goal?
We found some mistakes, and we've tried to improve them.
Appreciate your short answers. Another duty you listed was conducting the nation's monetary policy in pursuit of the statutory objective of maximum employment. Do you feel the Federal Reserve, under your leadership, has accomplished that goal?
We've moved monetary policy in as much as possible to try to support employment growth, but obviously a 10% unemployment rate is not very satisfactory.
Again, I appreciate your answers. For me, perhaps the biggest failure of, in the Federal Reserve and the political side here in Washington is that amid all of these failures, the politicians, the folks in the administration and Federal Reserve have claimed credit for saving the system while blaming capitalism and unrestrained free markets for our problems. That has justified the positions that are now being taken here in Congress in many ways to come back and even extend the control, the intrusion of the federal government further into the private sector. I think you've been a big part of orchestrating that and shifting the blame onto the private sector. No one's arguing that there's not blame to go around everywhere. But the biggest failure I've seen is the failure for us to recognize the role that we played and the lack of our oversight of Fannie Mae, who created a lot of these toxic assets and sold them around the world, the loose monetary policy that created chronically low unemployment rates and high leverage across the economy. By not taking some of the blame and making sure the public is aware of that, we've undermined the system that made this country prosperous. And I think that is an egregious error. I'd like to just mention a few things. What you say, the predictions you make, are critically important because we act on them, the whole world acts on them. I'd just like to mention a couple of these as we go along. March 28, 2007, when asked about the subprime market, and I quote, you said, "The impact of the broader economy and financial markets of the problems in the subprime market seems likely to be contained." A little later, May the 17th, 2007, you said, "We do not expect significant spillovers from the subprime market to the rest of the economy or to the financial system." A little later, February 28, 2008, on the potential bank failures, I quote, Among the largest banks, the capital ratios remain good, and I don't expect any serious problems of that sort among the large internationally active banks that make up a very substantial part of our banking system. Again, on June 9, 2008, I quote, "The risk that the economy has entered a substantial downturn appears to have diminished over the past month or so." On July 16th, right before our crash, 2008, speaking of Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, you said they're adequately capitalized and in no danger of failing. And to a large degree, the oversight that we're responsible for here in this Congress, we did not accomplish because of assurances that we've gotten over the years from your predecessor and from yourself. And by doing that, I think we egregiously failed the American system. Let me mention a few things here as I run out of time. Capitalism depends on capital, and I'd like to ask a couple of questions about the Federal Reserve and capital. Is the Federal Reserve an instrument of the government?
It's an agency of the government, yes.
Do you believe money is an instrument of government to be manipulated as necessary to calibrate the collective economic behavior of the public with the perceived financial needs of government?
The monetary policy is intended to follow the mandate the Congress gave the Federal Reserve, which is to achieve maximum employment and price stability. That's what we try to achieve.
Do you believe that employment should be a mission, a goal of the Federal Reserve?
Yes, I think the Federal Reserve can assist keeping employment close to its maximum level through adroit policies.
Should the government or an agency established by the government have the power to distort the purchasing power of money?
The Federal Reserve is mandated to achieve price stability, and the one thing you didn't mention in your list was inflation. Inflation has been low, and in that respect, the purchasing power of the dollar has been good. It's been stable.
In a free market economy, you would think that the cost of capital would fluctuate based on supply and demand. Yet a big part of the role of the Federal Reserve is to try to fix those interest rates. Is that a function that has been employed properly? Is that something that needs to be reconsidered?
Well, we always need to improve our execution, but I think that as evidenced by the fact that every major country in the world has a central bank and uses monetary policy, I think that's the system that we have determined is the most effective at this point.
Again, I appreciate your testimony. I would, again, as you and I have talked personally, ask you to consider the need to make the Federal Reserve more transparent. There's no reason that independence needs to mean secrecy. The confidence in the Federal Reserve, the mistrust around this country, has reached new heights, and we need to do something to restore the faith that the American people have in their monetary system, their financial system, and that responsibility is at the Federal Reserve as well as in the Congress. I would encourage you again to consider what type of openness or audit, as you and I have talked about, would be appropriate in order to reassure the American people that we're not looking at another Fannie Mae situation, that over years we were told not to worry, not to worry, everything is okay, and now we saw what it did. We can't allow that to happen with the Federal Reserve. But again, Mr. Chairman, thank you very much, and I yield back.
May I quickly respond?
Yes, sir.
Senator, on Fannie and Freddie, the Federal Reserve had been raising concerns about Fannie and Freddie for many, many years, so we were on the side of concerns about that. In terms of transparency, I think the Congress should have access to all of our financial information, financial operations, and the like, and we have made every effort to do that, and whatever remains to be done, we want to work with you to do that. Our main concern is about the independence of monetary policy itself and not about any financial aspect. So we are very much committed to transparency in all financial aspects of the Federal Reserve.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Senator Akaka.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Chairman Brunansky, I